Next, tobacco abuse. Tobacco is obtained from the plant Nicotiana tobacum and Nicotiana rustica. The dried and cured leaves of its young branches make the commercial tobacco used worldwide. Addiction to tobacco is due to nicotine, an alkaloid present in it. Nicotine is a stimulant, highly harmful and poisonous substance. Tobacco is used for smoking, chewing and snuffing. Inhaling tobacco smoke from cigars, cigarette, bidis, smoking pipes, smoking hookah is called smoking. When smoke is inhaled, the chemicals get absorbed by the tissue and cause some harmful effects. First, benzopyrene and polycyclic hydrocarbon present in tobacco is carcinogenic, that will causing lung cancer. Smoking causes inflammation of throat and bronchi, leading to conditions like bronchitis and pulmonary tuberculosis. Increased blood pressure caused by smoking leads to increased risk of heart disease. Inflammation of lungs alveoli decrease surface area for gas exchange and cause emphysema by smoking. Carbon monoxide of tobacco smoke binds to hemoglobin of RBC and decreases its oxygen carrying capacity and causing hypoxia in body tissue. Smoking also causes increased gastric secretion, which leads to gastric and duodenal ulcer. Tobacco chewing causes mouth cancer. May 31st is observed as No Tobacco Day. Anti-Tobacco Act was passed on May 1st, 2004. By 2030, tobacco is expected to be single biggest cause of death worldwide, accounting for 10 million deaths per year. Knowing the danger of smoking and chewing tobacco, adolescent and the old people need to avoid these habits. Proper counseling and medical assistance can help an addict to give up the habit of smoking. This is the only preventive measure of smoking. World Health Organization issued a directive under which all cigarette advertisement and packs carry a warning: smoking is injurious to health. Next, alcohol abuse. The consumption of alcohol is a social evil practiced by wealthier and poorer section of society. The dependence of alcohol is called alcoholism and the addict is termed as alcoholic. This is called alcohol abuse. Drinking of alcohol impairs one's physical, physiological and psychological function. There are some harmful effects for alcoholic person. For alcoholic person, their nerve cells get damaged, resulting mental and physical disturbance, and there is a lack of coordination of body organs. Sometimes blurred or reduced vision, or they may be lose their vision, result in road accident. Alcohol causes dilation of blood vessels, that is, making wider of blood vessel, which may affect the functioning of heart. Next, alcohol affects liver, leads to cirrhosis and formation of fibrous tissue. Because of alcohol, body loses its control and consciousness, leading to health complication, even to death. By concluding how drinking of alcohol affects the body, consumption of alcohol leads to liver damage called cirrhosis, reproductive dysfunction, pancreatitis, chronic heart failure, damage to brain function, and cause atherosclerosis. How to overcome the problem of alcoholic? First, education and counseling. Education and proper counseling will help the alcoholics to overcome their problem and stress, to accept failure in their life. By physical activity, individual undergoing rehabilitation should be channelized into healthy activities like hearing music, reading books, exercise, yoga, and meditation. Seeking help from parents and peer groups. When a problematic situation occurs, the affected individual should seek help and guidance from parents and peers. This would help them to share their feeling of anxiety and wrongdoing and get rid of the habit of alcoholism. Medical assistance. Individual should seek help from psychologist and psychiatrist to get relieved from this condition and to lead a relaxed and peaceful life. Alcohol de-addiction and rehabilitation programs are helpful to the individual so that they could get rid of the problem completely and can lead a normal, healthy life. Next, we are going to see diseases and disorders due to lifestyle modification. First, diabetes mellitus. It is a chronic metabolic disorder. In Greek, the word diabetes means running through. The word mellitus means sweet. It is characterized by increased blood sugar level due to insufficient, deficient, or failure of insulin secretion. There are two types of diabetes. Type 1. It is insulin-dependent diabetes mellitus. This is caused by destruction of beta cells of pancreas. It is characterized by abnormally elevated blood glucose level, that is hyperglycemia, resulting from inadequate insulin secretion. Genetic inheritance and environmental factor, that is infection due to virus and acute stress, are also the causes. The symptoms of diabetes mellitus type 1 are high blood sugar, weight loss, increased hunger, and increased thirst. The complications are kidney failure, cardiovascular disease, diabetic retinopathy, and food ulcer. The treatment of diabetes mellitus type 1 is insulin therapy. Type 2, non-insulin dependent diabetes mellitus, also called adult onset diabetes. In this case, insulin production by pancreas is normal, but its action is impaired. The target cell do not respond to insulin. It does not allow the movement of glucose into cells. The causes are multifactorial, which include increasing age, obesity, sedentary lifestyle, overeating, and physical inactive, are the causes of type 2 diabetes mellitus. 1 in every 8 individuals in India is a diabetic. The revised World Health Organization estimate for the year 2025 is 57.2 million diabetics in India. The average age for the onset of diabetes is 40 years, while it is 55 years in other countries. World Health Organization projects that diabetes will be the seventh leading cause of death by the year 2030. The most important symptoms of diabetes mellitus are hyperglycemia, increasing in blood glucose level. Next, polyuria, frequent urination. Due to frequent urination, the loss of water in body leads to thirst, resulting in increased fluid intake, that is polydipsia. Excessive glucose excreted in urine, that is glycosuria. Excess hunger due to loss of glucose in urine, that is called polyphagia. Finally, fatigue and loss of weight. These are the several metabolic alterations are associated with diabetes mellitus. Let's compare type 1 and type 2 diabetes mellitus. First, prevalence, that is the percentage of people affected. For type 1, it is 10 to 20%. For type 2, it is 80 to 90%, and this is most common. Second factor, age of onset. For type 1, it occurs within 20 years of age. For type 2, the age of onset is more than 30 years. The body weight of type 1 diabetic is normal or underweight. But for type 2, the body weight of diabetic patient is obese, that is overweight. Type 1 caused by insulin deficiency due to destruction of beta cells. In type 2, insulin secretion is normal, but target cell do not respond to insulin. The treatment for type 1 is insulin therapy, that is insulin administration is necessary through injection. For type 2, the treatment is it can be controlled by diet, exercise and medicine. Dietary management is essential for prevention and control of diabetes. Diabetic person should take green leafy vegetable, low carbohydrate and fiber rich diet are more appropriate. Carbohydrate should be taken in the form of starch and complex sugar. Refined sugar, that is sucrose and glucose, should be avoided. Green leafy vegetables, wheat, unpolished rice should be included in diet regularly. Commercially available insulin preparation are also used to maintain blood glucose level based on the type and severity of the condition. Exercise plays an important role in facilitating a good control of diabetes, in addition to strengthening and toning up the muscles. Education and awareness. People with diabetics should be educated on the nature of disease they have and the possibility of complication of the disease if blood sugar is not under control. Instruction regarding diet, exercise, meditation, yoga, and drugs should be explained in proper way.